Hundreds more Australians will soon be looking for work, with another two major companies announcing job cuts. Eddie Meyer joins us now. And Eddie, this is becoming an all too familiar headline.
Oh, it is indeed, Hermione. In this case, it's Caltex, which today announced that it would have to close its ageing, outdated refinery here in Sydney. It says it simply can't compete with newer, more efficient refineries in Asia. They're larger, labour is cheaper, and that means it's going to have to turn the Sydney refinery into an import facility. And of course, that means it's going to import its fuel from Asia. Now, what that means is 330 permanent jobs will be lost here in Sydney by 2014. Another 300 contractors will also lose their jobs, so 630 jobs in total. Caltex also wouldn't guarantee the future for workers at its Brisbane refinery. That's 660 jobs there, also in jeopardy. Now, today again, the Prime Minister forced to respond to questions about Australian workers losing their jobs.
A tough day, and these people would be thinking now, these hard-working Australians, what's my next job, what's my next opportunity? Caltex and the Australian government will be working to support them.
Now, Caltex wasn't the only company announcing job losses today. Qantas, again, announcing it will close a facility it co-owns at Tullamarine in Melbourne. That's another 164 workers forced to look for work. Hermione?
Eddie Meyer, thank you. A judge has called an elderly Brisbane man a coward for sending bullets and explosives to high-profile Australians. 81-year-old John Gilbert Gordon targeted everyone from the Prime Minister, a former Queensland Premier, an Archbishop, and even a bank boss. His postal tirade lasted 3 years. He was sentenced to 2.5 years jail. Julie Gillard's moving out of the Lodge, and it's not because of a Kevin Rudd comeback. The historic house is 85 years old and in need of a facelift. Work on the heritage-listed building will include replacing the roof, forcing Ms Gillard out within months. It's understood she'll spend more time at Kirribilli House in Sydney and her property in Melbourne, which is getting a security upgrade. And an Austrian daredevil sky jumper is about to leap into the record books. From this capsule, Felix Baumgartner leapt 29 kilometres above the earth. He reached speeds of nearly 900 kilometres an hour. It's his final test jump before he aims to go supersonic and jump from 37 kilometres high. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 13 degrees in Brisbane, 14 in Sydney, 10 in Melbourne, 11 in Adelaide, 10 degrees also in Perth.